Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen Wa usalli wa usallimu ala al-mab'uthi rahmatan lil alameen Nabiyyina Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam rasulah wa nabiyya Wa qad qala Allah ta'ala fil Qur'an al-majid a'udhu billahi min ash-shaytanir rajim Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim Subhanaka la ilma lana illa ma'allamtana innaka antal alimul hakeem Rabbi shrahli sadri wa yassirli amri Wahlul uqdata min lisani yafqahu qawli Allahumma du'atini layku ila rasulika mabad My respected believing brothers and sisters in Islam and brothers in humanity I greet you with a universal greeting Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh For our brethren, brothers and sisters of different faith May the guidance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be with you We thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala once again that Allah has given us this opportunity that you and I could sit in our homes and view another program, Let's Talk Islam with Imran Mohamed, bringing the lights of Islam to you and I in our homes. It's indeed a great honor and favor from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I hope and pray that our message tonight meet each and every one of us with good health and good strength. And may this program that we listen to be a means of guidance to guide us on the straight path, for us to understand our deen as Muslims and know Islam is a way of life for the entire humanity, not only Muslims, but it's a religion for the entire humanity. That we all could come in the obedience of the Creator, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we have been given this opportunity. So we will begin our program tonight as the, you know, we always do with the Quranic recitation from the glorious book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And you know, from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you know, told us that when the Quran is being recited, that we sit attentively and listen to what is being recited so that we will get the blessings and the barakah of the recitation, inshallah. So we will start our program with the beautiful Quranic recitation. I hope that all of us enjoy it and sit attentively and listen, inshallah.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إنا أرسلنا نوحا إلى قومه أن أنذر قومك من قبل أن يأتيهم عذاب أليم قال يا قوم إني لكم نذير مبين يا قوم إني لكم نذير مبين أن اعبدوا الله واتقوه وأطيعون يغفر لكم بكم ويؤخركم إلى أجل مسمى إن أجل الله إذا جاء لا يؤخر لو كنتم تعلمون قال رب إن دعوت قومي ليلا ونهارا فلم يزدهم دعائي إلا فرارا وإني كلما دعوتهم لتغفر لهم جعلوا أصابعهم في آذانهم واستغشوا ثيابهم وأصروا واستكبروا استكبارا ثم إني دعوتهم جهارا ثم إني أعلنت لهم وأسررت لهم إسرارا فقلت استغفروا ربكم إنه كان غفارا يرسل السماء عليكم مدرارا ويمددكم بأموال وبنين ويجعل لكم جنات ويجعل لكم أنهارا ما لكم لا ترجون لله وقارا وقد خلقكم أطوارا ألم تروا كيف خلق الله سبع سماوات ألم تروا كيف خلق الله سبع سماوات طباقا وجعل القمر فيهن نورا وجعل الشمس سراجا والله أنبتكم من الأرض نباتا ثم يعيدكم فيها ويخرجكم إخراجا والله جعل لكم الأرض بساطا لتسلكوا منها سبلا فجاجا قال نوح رب إنهم عصوني واتبعوا من لم يزده ماله وولده إلا خسارا ومكروا مكرا كبارا وقالوا لا تذرن آلهتكم ولا تذرن ودا ولا سواعا ولا يغوث ويعوق ونسرا وقد أضلوا كثيرا ولا تزد الظالمين إلا ضلالا مما خطيئاتهم أغرقوا فأدخلوا نارا فلم يجدوا لهم من دون الله أنصارا وقال نوح رب لا تذر على الأرض من الكافرين ديارا إنك إن تذرهم يضلوا عبادك ولا يلدوا إلا فاجرا كفارا رب اغفر لي ولوالدي ولمن دخل بيتي مؤمنا وللمؤمنين والمؤمنات ولا تزد الظالمين إلا تبارا.
صدق الله وصدق الرسول صدق الله العظيم. الله سبحانه وتعالى has spoke the truth. Alhamdulillah, that was our recitation of the glorious Quran. We beg and ask the Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that the Quran that we have recited or have been recited, may it be a means of barakah and blessings upon you and I. Subhanallah. You know, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said the Quran that every ayat or every letter that we recited, Allah give us 10 blessings. Inshallah, you and I in our homes that we have listened to it, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the blessings of it also. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala use this Quran that have been recited, that we have listened to also, to be a means of shifa'a, a means of cure for our sickness and our ailments. So our brothers and sisters who are sick, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you shifa un kamila by the recitation of the glorious Quran that you have listened to. And all those challenges and difficulties in our life, let it be a means to guide us on the straight path, on the path of Sirat al-Mustaqim. You know, our program, Let's Talk Islam, you know, with Imran Mohamed, alhamdulillah, brothers and sisters, it comes to you with the kind compliment of our, you know, generous donation from our brothers. You know, it come with a kind compliment of N&S Algo Custom Brokerage Service, V&B Supermarket, Wolf Furniture Store, Fat Boy Discount Store, and Al-Qayyim Academy. SubhanAllah, these brothers, it is only possible, you know, by the will and permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and also the generous donation and consideration of these brothers and sisters. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless them. May Allah bless their work and their business. Let it be a means of guidance and guide them on the straight path and bring them closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless them all and all. We ask all of us, ya Allah, to support their work, their business and their, you know, their work, so it be a means that Allah bless them, so that they were able to continue to sponsor our program, so that you and I were able to benefit, inshallah. Our feature presentation tonight will be done by Moulana Haseeb Hassan. Inshallah, I urge all of us to listen attentively to the words of Allah and His Rasul, so that you and I all will become, you know, obedient and take a lesson and a message from the program, inshallah. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen Wal Aqibatu Lil Muttaqeen Was Salatu Was Salamu Ala Ashraful Anbiya'i Wal Mursaleen Wa Ala Alihi Wa Ashabihi Ajma'een Amma Ba'd. Respected viewers, brothers and sisters in Islam, Assalamu Alaikum Wa Rahmatullahi Wa Barakatuh. Our non-Muslim friends, SubhanAllah, may the guidance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be with you all. We thank Allah, we praise Him, that Allah has given us this opportunity. لِأَنَّهُ مَحْمُودًا عَلَىٰ كُلِّ حَالٍ. Whatever condition, brothers and sisters, you are in, whatever state you are in, we must thank the Almighty subhanAllah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we ask Him to make it better for you and I. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us all and accept all of us, inshaAllah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have created you and I, brothers and sisters, and Allah have bring us into this life, and we are into this life without a choice. Allah have chose us and bring us into this ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, is to worship Him and to be obedient and subservient to Him. As brothers in Islam, you and I, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have created us to worship Him and be subservient to Him. And we need to live a good life in this life that we have lived, recognizing the rights of one another, obeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and fulfill our duties to one another. Being a Muslim and being a reciter of the kalima la ilaha illallah Muhammad or Rasulullah make us all one brotherhood, or one unit of obedience, or one unit in which we all worship and obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And for this reason, you and I, brothers and sisters, we must have that love for one another. That love that the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam taught his companions, that your brother in Islam or your brother in humanity, we must love, then honor and respect one another. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and this is how our religion, brothers, we're as human beings, we are all one brother. If we go back, we all came from Adam and Eve alayhi salatu wasalam. So we are all one brother in Islam and we are one brother in humanity. And we must honor and respect that, and respect the rights of one another, subhanAllah. And this is one of the great teachings of Islam. This is one of the great teachings of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, that he came and he taught his companions, and who have passed it on from one generation to the next, so that it meet you and I, that you and I are brother to one another. And we must respect the rights and obey Allah and respect the rights of one another. We should not do things to cause harm to our brothers, to cause harm to our sisters in any way possible. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam tells us in a beautiful ahadith, Imam Bukhari and Imam Muslim have made mention of this narration. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, Al-Muslimu Man salima al-muslimuna min lisanihi wa yadihi. Allahu Akbar. Beautiful words of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He says that a true believer in Allah, a true Muslim, is that Muslim whose other Muslim or other human beings is safe from his hand and his tongue. Now, in this hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the Prophet of Allah used min lisanihi wa yadihi. He used his tongue first and then his hand. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, the best believer is that believer who other believer is safe from his tongue and his hand, meaning that you will not use your tongue or your language to be abusive to one another, to be indecent to one another, to be, subhanAllah, ridicule one another with your speech, you talk bad about one another, to humiliate and to disgrace one another. SubhanAllah, how beautiful is the word of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that we should not at any time as a believer insult and ridicule and oppress one another with our tongue. We should not talk things bad about one another. Sometimes in life we hear things about another. We shouldn't be the one to go and talk about it so that we defamed our brother, subhanAllah, so that we disgraced our brother. We should be the one, if we want to know, to find out the situation and be a means of advice and guidance to him, how he takes it forward. Allahu Akbar. That is why the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam tells us that you should not, the honor, protecting the honor of a person is that when you hear things about him or when you will say things, don't say things that will degrade him or make him look low or insignificant in the eyes of people. Disrespectful, subhanAllah. And this is our teachings and our Islam that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, brothers and sisters, have taught us that we want to be a good Muslim is that we other brothers and sisters are protected from our tongue. We don't say bad things about them. We don't say abusive things about them. And this is the beautiful teachings of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So the best you and I could be as a believer is that we don't say things that will cause harm to a brother, or say things that when someone hears it, they'll look down upon him. No, that's not the quality and the traits of a believer. Because you and I as Muslims are a believer to another, so we safeguard him from our tongue, so that we don't say things that will cause harm to him and discredit him, subhanAllah. Min lisani, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam say, your tongue, wa yadihi, and your hand, subhanAllah, you don't do things with your hand to harm him, to take what belongs to him, or to oppress him, or to fight, or to hit him. We don't use our hand in that way that we cause harm, to take his property, or to take, harassing him, whether we, hit him, or whether we take what belongs to him. We don't use our hand in that aspect that we cause difficulties and harm to our brother, subhanAllah. So the first hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the best al-muslimu man salim al-muslimuna min lisanihi wa yadihi, the best of you believer is that who other believer is safe from your, other human beings is safe from your hand and your tongue. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam continues in a hadith Imam Tirmizi have made mention of the narration. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, al-mu'minu aminahu nasu. He says that a true believer is that believer whom other believer or other believer is saved from his property is safe from him and his wealth is safe from him. His trust, dima'ihim wa amwalihim, his trust and his life and his possession is safe from him. SubhanAllah, beautiful. Hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, wal mu'minu, and a believer, aminahun nas ala dima'ihim wa amwalihim, his life, his trust, his life, and his possession is saved by another one. SubhanAllah. The possession of a believer, we should be the one that no harm to come to that for him because he's our brother. And his possession also, that we, his life, that we don't do anything to harm him in any way, as well as to take his possession or that which belongs to him. We should not be a person who find ourselves that our believers possession is unsecure in our presence or in our eyes in any way possible. SubhanAllah, this is a brother to a brother. This is what you and I as believers should be to humanity. Their belongings, whatever belongs to them, it is our rights to protect it, that we don't take it wrongfully, that we don't take it oppressively, and their life and their possession. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, a true believer is that believer who other believer is saved from that. SubhanAllah. And this is the word of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, brothers and sisters, that we need to implement into our lives, that we, if we do that, and that consideration of one brother to another, that his life and his trust and his possession is safeguarded with you and I, then we will live in a world that is very peaceful. As subhanAllah, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam taught us that we lived together with love and unity for one another, and then the help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will come. So in regarding to this, brothers and sisters, we need to honor the rights of one another. Honor the rights of, you and I as believers, so that we'll be good brothers, or we will be good brother to one another in the eyes of Allah, in which we will always dear and look out for one another and safeguard one another in their rights, their life and their position. This is one of the great qualities that Islam have taught us, and for humanity and believers, that we all could look out for the rights of one another. Don't try to abuse one another or abuse it or misuse it. That rights a brother have upon you is that you protect his life and his trust and his honor in any way possible, as well as his position. You don't cause it to be degraded. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam tells us that the concern that we should have, that's one, and the other concern, that our brothers and sisters in need and wants, our brothers who are suffering, it should also be a part of us that is suffering. When we see our brothers and sisters, our brothers in humanity in different parts of the world is being suffered, is being challenged. You know, and a beautiful hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Al mu'minu karajulin wahid." He says that the believer are like one. The believers are like one person. In ishtaka aynuhu, ishtaka kulluhu. If his eyes hurt, then his entire body hurts. Subhanallah. وَإِنْ اِشْتَكَى رَأْسُهُ, and if his head hurts, اِشْتَكَى كُلُّهُ, then the entire body hurts. Allahu Akbar. Look at the word of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, brothers and sisters. He says that we as believers, we are like one body. You know, when our eyes hurt, then our entire body should feel that pain. When our heads hurt, then our entire body feel that pain. All the brothers in Islam, we are like one body. When one is challenging, or when one of our brothers and our sisters in a different country, or in our country, or in different parts of the world, go through challenges, go through difficult situation, go through hardships, then that should worry and concern us. We should feel that pain. We should feel that agony for them. We have our brothers and sisters in the world. They are suffering from food, shortage of food. They are suffering from clothes, hunger, oppression, hardships and challenges facing them, subhanallah. And we see the difficult situation that they faced and challenges that they faced. It should hurt us. It should worry us. We should lend out a helping or a merciful hand to them, subhanallah, so that we will aid them. We will assist them in whatever way is our capability. Whatever way we could do, we should have that, subhanallah. We should feel it. And if we could help and assist them, then we should do that. When any brother come to us for anything and we could help and assist them, then we should do that in any way possible, according to our means and ability, because that is what Allah loves. When we could look for our brothers and look out for them, feel their agonies and pain if we can't help them, because we are one brothers. Allahu Akbar. Subhanallah. Glory be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is our teachings. So when we see on the TV and we see on the television, we see our brothers, whether it's in China, whether it's in, you know, Afghanistan, whether it's in Iraq and Iran, they are suffering, then subhanallah, we can help them. We are so far, then we should feel that pain for them, subhanallah, and pray that the Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help them. Recover them from their challenges and their difficulties. You know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, brothers, when we could help and we could assist as a brother, for a brother, subhanallah, then we should help. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loved that goodness and kindness to humanity. Allah loved that goodness and kindness to brotherhood, because we are all one. We are all one human being, and we should show that love and honor and respect to one another. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Imam Tirmizi also make mention of the narration. He says, "Ar-rahimuna yarhamuhu ar-rahman, irhamu man fil ardi yarhamkum man fis sama." Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, the merciful Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have mercy upon the kind, have mercy upon the generous individual that will worry and concern about his brothers and sisters. When he could help them, he could assist them, he do it. He says, Allah have mercy upon those people, subhanallah. So he says, you people have mercy upon those, or your brothers, upon your sisters, upon one another as human beings. He says, have mercy upon them. So the people on earth have mercy upon one another, and the one in heaven, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will have mercy upon you. Subhanallah. When we are in a position and in a state that we could help and we could assist our brethren, help and assist our brothers, subhanallah, then we should do it. We should help our brothers, assist them, because this attracts the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If we can't and it's out of our reach, then we should feel their pain. We should feel their suffering, because we are all one brotherhood. We should respect that rights of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that brotherhood, fulfill our responsibilities and our duties towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and be kind and be thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and help and assist our brothers in Islam. Subhanallah. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, brothers, he says that whomsoever has been deprived of gentleness and kindness to one another, and does not concern about one another, doesn't feel that pain of our brothers and sisters throughout the world, he says, subhanallah, he says, such a person have been deprived of a great good from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A great, great good. So we should live in peace, brothers and sisters. Love one another for the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Respect the rights and fulfill the duties to our brothers in Islam, our brother in humanity. Live with peace and honor, and feel that pain that our brothers are suffering in the world, which we cannot help or assist. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam tells us, he says, لا يدخل الجنة. He says, none of you could enter Jannah hatta tu'minu, until you believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, one God Almighty, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wala tu'minu hatta tahabu. Beautiful words of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He says, wala tu'minu, and you could never become a believer, hatta tahabu, until you have love amongst yourself. Until you have love and you'll respect the rights and protect the honor and the possession of one another. Because when we have love for one another, then his property, his life, his trust, his irdi, his honor is safeguarded and protected by you and I. He says, subhanallah, he says that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we cannot enter the paradise until we have this love for one another. Love for one another, that we feel the pain also of our brothers who we can't help and assist in different parts of the world. He says, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, أَوَلَا أَدُلُّكُمْ عَلَى شَيْءٍ. He says, should I not show you upon something, إِذَا فَعَلْتُمُوهُ, that if you do it, تَحَابَبَتُمْ, that it will bring this love amongst you. He says, أَفْشُ السَّلَامَ بَيْنَكُمْ, spread peace amongst yourself by the greetings, assalamu alaikum. I'm telling you that peace be upon you. I should not have any hatred or malices in my heart for you. And subhanallah, when I say peace be upon you, I mean that all goodness should be upon you. Subhanallah. Peace, you are saved from me. You are safe from everything for me, from my hand and my tongue. You are safe from me when we say salam. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, spread that peace amongst yourselves. Subhanallah. That will bring that love amongst yourself as brethren, as brothers in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us to understand our rights and our duties and our responsibility to one another, that we spread peace amongst all of us as an individual. Subhanallah. There is a beautiful hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Abu Dawood and Imam Bukhari. As make mention of the narration of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he says that al-mu'minu mir'atul mu'min, Allahu Akbar. The words of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is miraculous, brothers and sisters. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, al-mu'minu mir'atul mu'min, wal-mu'minu akhul mu'min, yakufu alaihi dai'atuhu wa yuhutuhu min wara'ihi, Allahu Akbar. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he says that a believer is a mirror unto a believer. We are a mirror unto one another, and we are a brother unto one another, and a believer safeguard him from destruction. Subhanallah. A believer unto a believer is like a mirror, one. Two, it's like we are a brother unto a brother, or we are brothers to one another, and we safeguard him from destructions. And subhanallah, we protect him in his absence. Allahu Akbar. Protect him in his absence. Look at the words of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, brothers and sisters. We are a mirror unto one another. We are a brother unto one another. We protect him from destruction, meaning we protect him if any harm will come his way. If any challenges will come his way, we protect him from being destroyed and being destruction. Subhanallah. And we protect him in his absence. Even he's not around us, then subhanallah, we don't say things or do things to bring harm to him. We don't do things to degrade him in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or in the eyes of people. We don't say things, and this go back to our saying towards one another or what we hear about one another, so that it be a means of destruction and be a means of disobedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is the rights that a brother have upon you and I, brothers and sisters, subhanallah. Look at the word, how it's a miracle from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Look at the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, he says, a believer is a mirror unto a believer. Brothers and sisters, when we look at a mirror, and we look at a mirror, what is it that we see? We see the reflection of ourselves. A mirror is what we look to see our beauty, Allahu Akbar. We use a mirror to see how beautiful we are, or to comb our hairs, or to groom our beards, to see how beautiful you and I look, subhanAllah. And when we look at a mirror, then we should see the beauty of our brothers also, because we are seeing a reflection of ourselves. That is why the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam have taught us, look at the words, we are a mirror. So when we look at a mirror, then we see the reflection, not of ourselves, but also of our brother. That our brother, we are a mirror to one another. Then when we look at the mirror and what we see, we want to see beauty, we want to see goodness within ourselves. Subhanallah. So likewise, when we look at that, then we should see our brother also, that we want the same for them. Ah, subhanallah. And the scholars, جزاهم الله خير خير الجزاء. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless them, for they have expanded and they have elucidated and they have expounded and they have explained this in more details for you and I to understand. You know, subhanallah. The mirror, that this hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam that he quotes, the mirror, subhanallah. When we look at a mirror, you know, there are certain parts of our body, there are certain organs of our body, brothers and sisters, that we can't see. There are certain things that we can't see in our body parts. We could only see it when we look at a mirror, subhanallah. If we have a scar on our face or on our neck, we will look into the mirror to see it, so that we will, you know, try to beautify it or hide it in whatever way possible, because we can't see it. So we go and we look at a mirror, you know, to see that, because we cannot see it without a mirror. And we try to rectify it. Subhanallah. Likewise, a believer, when we look at a believer and we see things, subhanallah, that is there, that is our brother is going wrong, then we will be able to rectify it. Subhanallah. Just as how we look at the mirror to see our scars, or look at something that is on our face, our nose, our eyes, that we can't see without a mirror, and we will try to benefit it. Subhanallah, this is how a believer should be to another believer, brothers and sisters. Subhanallah, when we look at one another and we see the faults in one another, then we will be able to rectify them. Subhanallah. We will be able to help one another and the mistakes. So when you are arrogant, then your brother will see that, so he will try to educate you. Subhanallah. This is what the benefit that a brother should do upon one another. When the Prophet ﷺ used, we are a mirror to one another. This is, you know, some of the features or the qualities of a mirror. One is that it allows us to see the faults of one another, or allows us to see the fault of ourselves, so that we will able to rectify it. So when we look at a believer and we see the faults of one another, so we will try to rectify it. Subhanallah. So when we are arrogant, then our brother should be there to educate us. When we are heedless to our duties towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, first quality of the mirror, that, you know, it shows us that we see our faults and our limbs that we cannot see except through it, but the believer could see it, and then he will be able to educate us. So when we are heedless in the disobedience, or heedless towards obeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and your brother is there to remind you, to bring you on course. Subhanallah. One of the first benefit of the mirror is that it shows us our mistakes. And when we look at a believer to a believer, and if he sees that, then we should be the one to remind us to come to the better, subhanallah, better way and better obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the organs that we cannot see, on our body, on our faces, then the mirror allows it to see it, subhanAllah. So to our brother, we are a mirror. We are a mirror unto a brother. Then when we stand and we face each other, then he will able to see what we don't see, so that he will remind us. And you know, subhanAllah. And this refers to he will able to remind us in the obedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when we fall short. The second quality of a mirror, brothers and sisters, is that a mirror is honest. Subhanallah. The mirror is honest. Exactly whatever, when we stand in front of the mirror, whatever we see on the mirror, that is exactly what it is, because the mirror don't lie. Subhanallah. Likewise, a believer should be honest to one another. We should not lie to one another. When the Prophet ﷺ used a mirror, this is what he's actually telling us, that believers should be honest to one another. We should be honest that, subhanallah, if we look good, then we should tell when we do good, brothers, you tell you that you do good. Subhanallah. You're a good person. The mirror shows that appearance to you. You're beautiful. You're handsome. So likewise, a believer, when we look to one another, as the Prophet ﷺ said, we are a mirror unto one another. And when we look to one another, then we see that honesty with one another. We tell one, you're beautiful and you're good. And if it is bad, if it look bad on you, subhanAllah, he tell you and he helps you to make it better. You know, this look good does not look good on you. And a believer should be that to a believer. As the word the Rasul ﷺ used, a mirror unto a believer. So when we look at the mirror, then we see, subhanAllah, exactly what we see, that is what it is. Subhanallah. Likewise, a believer should be to a believer. When you're good, you let them know that what you're doing is good. But when you're wrong, also you highlight it to them. Brother, this is what you do is wrong. Just as how you will see it in the mirror. Just your believer should be of that individual state that he will be able to tell you. When you fall short, he will tell you that you fall short. Subhanallah. Second quality of the mirror. Subhanallah. So the first one, it highlights on our organs, the mirror, our faults. So too, a believer should identify the faults in us and help us to better it. And also, secondly, it tells us the truth, what it is. So, subhanAllah. So when you believe or unto a believer, we should tell one another the truth and help one another to make it better. Subhanallah. The third quality of the mirror, as the scholars have mentioned, is that the mirror, it never exaggerated or magnify it. Subhanallah. When we see a scar on our face, it never, you know, it is bigger than what it looks. It is right here. Subhanallah. And the mirror, it tells you exactly what it is. So you don't exaggerate or you don't magnify it. Likewise, a believer should be straight to the point. Just not magnify or exaggerate what you are doing. It should be to the point, brothers, that what you are doing is wrong. And this is what it is. It is small. And that we leave it like that. We don't make it bigger or we don't magnify it, whether in the eyes of people or in the eyes of the individual. So the mirror, when we looked at it for our scars or whatever it is, it tells us exactly the magnitude of it. We see it. It don't speak, but we see it. So it's of that surface. It is of that nature. It's not too big. It is what it is. So it tells us exactly. It shows us exactly what it is. It does not exaggerate nor magnifies it. And if it does like that, a believer, you and I, brothers and sisters, we should be like that to one another. We should not exaggerate ourselves to one another, brothers and sisters. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he tells us that we are a mirror unto a believer. Whatever it is we see in the believer, we let it be to that extent. We don't magnify it. Four qualities of the mirror. The scholars have mentioned that we are a mirror unto a believer is that the mirror is silent. Subhanallah. It shows you what it is. It is silent. It does not scream. It does not shout. It does not yell at us, in spite of whatever the nature it is. Subhanallah. Subhanallah. The advice that it gives us, very gentle, is that what it is. That is why you and I as believers, we should be very gentle to one another. If we see someone like the mirror, the quality of the mirror, it is, subhanallah, it is gentle. It is silent. It does not shout and ridicule your faults and your problem. We should be like a mirror to one another, in that whenever we see, we should, you know, gently and politely tell our brothers. We shouldn't, all of us, sometimes we make mistakes and we make faults, brothers and sisters, but we should not be that we insult one another and yell at one another and tell them their problem, their faults and their mistakes. Imam Shafi'i rahimahullah, he says that, oh my brother, if you find a fault in me. He says, pull me aside and tell me it. He says, I will listen to you day until night what you are telling me. He says, but do not tell me in public places, because I might be in doubt whether you are trying to bring me on the straight path, or you are trying to degrade me, or you are trying to insult me, subhanAllah. Like the mirror, very silently, it tells you what is it with you. Like a believer, we should be very silently when we tell one another. Don't yell and don't, you know, be big and bold with it. We should gently, politely remember our brothers and sisters, subhanAllah. So Imam Shafi tells you that. He says that, do it aside and tell me very humbly, and you know, because you are trying to help me and assist me, and that is how believers should be, that we try to help and assist one another. Brothers and sisters, this is the quality of a mirror, and this is what believers should have with one another. The fifth quality of the mirror, in conclusion, brothers and sisters, and there are many more, but our time will not permit us to. The scholars have mentioned that a mirror, when you walk away from a mirror, the mirror is silent. It does not give your identity to anyone. The mirror don't identify you to another. So when another person come in front of the mirror, he doesn't say, it's a good thing that you have come. The person before you were like this and were like that. SubhanAllah, the mirror is very silent and it does not tell another about your things. SubhanAllah. That is why the Prophet ﷺ said, a believer is a mirror unto a believer. Whatever is the faults and the wrong of a believer to a believer, then it should be between you and that believer. You should not tell this one and tell that one. That is why the Prophet ﷺ used a believer is a mirror unto a believer. So our problems and our difficulties, our hardships, our wrongdoings, we should not tell one another. Our wrong things that we do, we should not tell one another. Like the mirror keeps it silently when he sees it, so to a believer unto a believer, you should not be that you tell this one and tell that one. You should be within yourself. SubhanAllah, don't whisper to another, and you don't go and whisper the wrong of a brother towards another. SubhanAllah. And this is something, brothers and sisters, that we should try to control. You know, beautiful words of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and the scholars have explained the mirror, how we should be to a believer. We should be of that nature, you know, that we should not, you know, people, brothers and sisters, we don't find the faults in ourselves, we find faults in other. And the way in which we do it, as the Prophet ﷺ, is that we advise our brother in the best way possible. And these ways that have been mentioned is the best way that we do it for the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us all, brothers and sisters. Let us live as brothers in Islam. Let us live in brothers in humanity, respecting the rights to one another, and safeguard and protect the honor and position of each and every one of us is sacred in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the best amongst you who other believers is safe from his hand and his tongue, meaning you don't do things or say things to oppress him or degrade him in any way possible. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us all and accept all of us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us to whatever is being said, that we learn it, implement it into our lives, into the life of our family members and all of us, inshallah. Wa qina wa alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Alhamdulillah, brothers and sisters, that's the end of our program. You know, all of us, inshallah, tune into our program. We could view the program on the TV program, that is on every Monday night, inshallah. And also we could view it on Facebook and on YouTube. You know, it is there for our benefits, and these are there that all of us could learn, and we could share it to one another so that we will be able to benefit from the message, inshallah. I urge you and ask you all, brothers and sisters, you know, to pray for all of us, or pray for one another, especially our sponsors who have sponsored this program and make it, you know, a means that you and I could benefit from the teachings of Allah and His Rasul, and support their work and support their business, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless them and bless all of us with good health and good strength. Until next time, wa qina wa alhamdulillahi rabbil alamin. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Ya Rasul salam alayka, ya Habib salam alayka, salawatullah alayka. Salli ala nabi wa tabas. ذكر الرسول تشحن.
حاذ الهمة يا ربي بجاه النبي أزيح الغمة يا ربي.
Now you can really go shopping in Lenora at V&P Supermarket 20 North Lenora Public Road. Come in and enjoy great prices on the widest range of groceries, beverages, frozen meats and vegetables and ice cream too, even food for your pets. Get detergents and bathroom soaps and cleaners, the full range and all the brands. Pots and pans for the kitchen, cutlery and crockery for dining. And all the household items you need to make home so comfortable. The ladies will love our cosmetics collection, perfect for gifts for special occasions and just what you promised yourself. V&P Supermarket 20 North Lenora Public Road, West Coast, Demerara.
Gönüllerde hasret